in dealing with osmosis and kind of our lipid bilayer here. And that's going to be our main emphasis, is this lipid bilayer, this egg shell looking thing with the French fries in the middle. Yeah, sorry, is how I kind of see it. But you'll find online there's a lot of different artist rendition on how this looks, but I think overall this is kind of what we're shooting for. We're not going to be focusing on the cholesterol or any of the proteins here, or any of this. We're just going to kind of like look at our little eggshell layer here. And I highly recommend going online and doing research on what we're going to be doing here. And for other professionals that actually do medical animation and illustration for a living, they got a lot of good resources, and they have a really good knowledge base of what they're going to be doing. But for some people that have never done it before or aren't that familiar, it's a crash course, so it's good to go online and do research. So we will be focusing on this here. So why don't we use this as just a rough reference point right now, and we'll kind of get started. We're going to start modeling our kind of eggshell looking heads here, and these little heads here are called our little hydrophilic heads, and these little tails attached are our hydrophobic tails. So we're going to kind of begin with that. So let's get started. I'm going to go ahead and just start with a sphere here, and let's go ahead and change this to a hexahedron. I'm going to actually bring my segments down to let's go for 10. Then I'm going to hit C on my keyboard to make it editable, so we can have an editable mesh here. And we're going to go to our poly mode live selection tool, and I'm going to go ahead and click on our polys here, hold down shift, and these aren't perfect in size and or shape, but why don't we go ahead and just kind of play with what we have here. These things aren't going to be perfect in nature. They're not going to be perfectly symmetrical, so we don't need to worry about too much on any of these points lining up with each other. We can definitely refine that later, but for right now, let's get kind of our basic cage down. So why don't we go ahead and just with these polys, let's extrude this out. And let's go ahead. I'm gonna go to my edge mode here, grab my live selection. I'm gonna kind of grab these edges here, and I'm just gonna kind of scale this in just a bit, just so it's not too crazy. Back to our poly mode, and I'm actually going to right click. I'm gonna go to my normal scale, kind of bring that in, and then I'm gonna actually go back to extrude. And let's go ahead and just extrude that out just a little more. And then what I'm going to do is kind of scale this in. And it's getting a little wonky right now, but we'll go ahead and fix that here in a bit. I'm going to go back to my edge mode, live selection. I'm going to actually hold down control and deselect these edges, because I do want to have these up here selected. And we're just going to kind of even this out, just bring it down a fraction. I'm going to go back to my poly mode. Let's go ahead and scale that in just a bit. All right, right click and extrude once again. And we can actually pull this up just a bit. Go ahead and just kind of scale that in a little more, because they get a little thin at the tips here, go and bring up a reference image again. And we can kind of see they're kind of squiggly. Each one is different, which is good. And we'll be able to kind of play around with this down the road a little bit. So I'm back in edge mode. I'm going to kind of try to balance this out a little bit. Live selection. I'm going to deselect these and kind of scale this in just a bit and just bring it down. So we notice there's kind of a wide gap here. It kind of looks like a tooth. And sometimes they do. But let's go ahead and just kind of just bring these up just a little more. And then I'm going to go ahead and go to my points mode. I'm going to go to my live selection, my rectangle selection. I'm going to make sure that visible elements, select visible elements, is clicked off. And I'm just going to highlight these, hold down shift, bring those up. just a smidgen here. And I think we could probably afford to do the same with these bottom ones here. Let's just give it a little bit of room to grow here. Check that out. Bring those up. These are a little wonky too. I'm going to grab these outside points. Kind of bring these up just a smidge. And we kind of have a pretty wide gap here. I think we're okay, but you know what? I'm actually gonna grab my my edge, get in edge mode here, and I'm just gonna kind of select these edges. I'm just gonna bring them in just a bit here, just so they're not so far away, and kind of bring that up a fraction. So we got a pretty good start here, I think. This is our basic cage, and you know, what we're going to need to do is kind of round out our model here a little bit in these edges. So I think what we want to do is kind of go into our poly mode here, and I think we want to hit Control A to select all. So we want to select all our polys. And I'm going to go ahead and right click, and I don't think you can see it, but I'm going to grab my subdivide down here, and I'm going to bring that up. And it defaults to one, and I think we're okay with that. And I want to make sure that my hyperNURB subdivide is on, and we're going to okay that. And so we get a relatively good organic look here. My only concern are these points. I don't think we want to get too sharp with that. So what I'm going to do is just kind of go into my live selection points mode. We're going to grab these, hold down shift to select, just kind of bring them down. But I'm going to go to my side view here. Just kind of zoom in, just kind of see what we're looking at here. I don't really want them to be too pointy like a knife. Oops, didn't want to do that. So I think we are okay with that. My only concern is these edges right here. I don't want to get any serious mesh distortions. We're not going to be subdividing this anymore, but you know, once we move down the line and we just kind of randomize what we're doing, I don't want any to get any crazy distortions. So I'm going to go back into my side view here, and I'm actually going to go to my live selection. I'm going to make sure that the visible elements are turned off, and I'm going to select these, and I'm going to go back to my perspective view here. And as you can see, they're all selected. I'm going to kind of bring that up just a fraction here. And they're a little offset, so we're just going to scale that in just a little bit. So there we go. Okay, better. Not too crazy, not too intricate, but you know, it's a good start. So I think with that, I'm going to want to really kind of discombobulate our model here. So I think what I'm going to do is kind of go to my views here, kind of center everything up here. Let's do that. I think this is our top here. And I'm going to grab our brush tool. I'm going to go to my polygon mode here. I'm going to actually deselect everything here. Let's go ahead and deselect. And let's go to my brush. And I think we're okay with the default settings. It might be a little big, but let's just kind of play around. But I kind of want to, you know, kind of pull this out a little bit here. You know, you can probably afford to probably dumb down our settings a little bit, but I'm just trying to get a simple rendition here of our little eggshell head and tails here. So kind of mess it up a bit here. A little too wonky, so let's just go ahead and kind of bring that up a smidge. And we want it to look a little off, if you will. Maybe, you know, make one a little bit longer than the other. Kind of bring that in a fraction. Maybe kind of offset it a bit like that. You know, we can probably even afford to go to our single view here in our perspective and kind of just kind of do that. You know, we're getting a pretty good idea of what we're looking at here. A little wide. Kind of bring that in. And we don't need to be focusing too much time on this. like I said, you know, once you do research and you see how these little buggers are made up, you can see that not too much time needs to go into it. So I think this looks all right. Overall feel to what we're going for here. And you know, we're dealing with kind of an electron microscope image, if you will, given it's going to be a little more stylized than that. But you know, we're dealing with something that's on a very small scale, something that's being seen through one of these micron microscopes. And I pulled up a example image here, and you can see realistically, this is what we would be wanting to kind of go for, kind of this incredibly small, tiny little element. And you can see that you have this heavy Fresnel effect, and just kind of, you know, very much being wrapped by light, basically is what we're looking at here. So with that, let's go ahead and kind of begin here with working on a material. And we're not going to spend too much time on what we're going for here, because it's not really that in depth, but it'll give a relatively good effect once we're finished here. So I'm going to go ahead and kind of I'm going to throw in a gradient here. We're going to do a 2D circular because we want it to kind of wrap a little bit. And there's many attributes here that we can work with now or later. Something of this nature, we're going to want to maybe revert back to a few of these channels and kind of play around and do some R&D on what we're going for. But right now, we're just kind of get our basic setup here. So we got a color channel here. We got our gradient. We could probably go ahead and give it, oh, I don't know, something warm. Probably keep it on the darker side here. Go with that, and then we're going to want to. This is going to be our key element here, our environment. We're going to turn this off here because we don't really want to deal with any environment reflections or anything like that. So we'll kill that, and then let's go in here and add our Fresnel. And this is kind of where the magic is going to lie. So this area is going to give us as most of the control. So why don't we just kind of play around with colors here? And like I said, personally, I want to stick with kind of the warmer side here. So maybe a kind of yellowy, like a very pale looking kind of yellow here. Oh, maybe a little bit more around there. And just keep it relatively light. And then here's where we're going to really want to kind of do the opposite. Maybe a little bit more of a red, maybe a burnt orange. I think that's a real color, right? Burnt orange. Kind of shooting for that. And like I said, we're probably going to be coming back and forth and just kind of tweaking this to our liking, but this will give us our foundation. So let's go ahead and just add a bump. And once again, this is personal preference. I kind of like to mix it up a little bit, so I'm going to just be working with a fusion channel so we can kind of fuse some bump and noise together to kind of break it up a little bit. So we'll go ahead and add a noise channel here, and then we're going to add a noise channel here. And for this one, I think I'm going to go ahead and go with Luca. I kind of like how it gives it that kind of sharpness to it, but I'm going to actually crank up my global scale here. So let's do that. And then go back to this noise channel. And I think I'm going to go ahead and use Naki because it has a much more organic feel to it. So I'm going to put that up, actually double that around 200. So it gives a little bit of diversity here in our feel. I think, oh, and we actually need to blend these two together. So once again, personal preference. I'm just going to kind of start with just 50%, cutting it right in half and see what it does. And I might double this just to get a larger effect. And our specular, it depends on the image. Sometimes you want to go for kind of a very sheen or wet look, you know, or you may just want to kind of dull the surface a little bit or not have any at all. You know, it really depends. You know, if you see some of these images here once again, you're not going to see much specular on the main surface here. You know, some of these raised displacement here, you might want to work in some specular, but you know, let's see where this takes us. So I'm just going to kind of keep it at a minimum here, just so we can pick up some of those highlights down the road once we start integrating lighting and whatnot. So let's go ahead and just apply this. We can slap it on our geometry here, and it's pretty washed out looking. But you know, given we don't have any lighting in there yet, but you can see that we're getting this nice kind of backlit kind of rim light, and I like that. But it's our foreground here. The front of our geometry, it's a little washed, so that's why we want to kind of come back, kind of work around what we're going for here. You know, we can probably, if it's too much, we could probably take that down, but I think it's going to really dull it, so I don't think we want to do that too much. Let's just kind of see what we have here. This might bring out our rim light a little bit more. Once again, you know, I'm going to keep that just at a minimum. So I think our gradient might be a little too bright. We don't want to blend these colors too much. Let's try to work in a little bit of turbulence here, and you can see it kind of breaks it up a bit. And I think that's not a bad idea. So I do kind of like that. Maybe that's a little too much. Let's take that down. Let's see how this is looking over here. Okay, cool. And, you know, well, like I mentioned, this is personal preference. You know, you saw the image that I was working with originally, so we're going to kind of go for that feel, kind of like this warm color. And there's a lot to do here. So I would definitely recommend playing around with a lot of these colors, like, you know, to get that heavy kind of X-ray feel, like in our previous image or example image. You know, this is going to be our primary ticket. So play around with colors here. You know, darken it up, play with the lighter side of things. And really, our possibilities are endless. You know, and we can always revert back if we don't like it, you know, once we get later on working with lighting. But this is our final graph module, the cloner object. And I would like to give a mad shout out to Maxon for having this thing, because it has saved me more times than I can count. It's a great, great tool. So why don't we go ahead and use our grid array here. And as we recall, there's a specific kind of alignment to these things. Kind of like that. So we're going to kind of mimic that, and we're just going to kind of focus on an area where our camera will ultimately lie. So let's kind of build onto that. So let's kind of drop everything down here and just kind of start from scratch. Oops. All right, definitely don't want that. So this is good. Running along our Z here. Crank this up a bit, maybe go to 3,000. Actually, why don't we go to 6,000? Just to give us enough room to kind of play here. Kind of fill it in. And this is, once again, just like everything else, you just kind of get a feel, kind of trial and error this. And this is obviously going to be our, at least for right now, this will be our bottom layer, because ultimately we'll have two. You know what, I'm actually going to, just to play it safe, I'm going to crank this up to 8,000. Just so we have plenty of room to play with. Kind of squeeze them together. Don't really need to cross into, or have them overlap. I think that's pretty okay, and we can always change that down the road if we don't like it. So let's kind of start populating across here. Kind of moving it. Kind of go to our side views here. Maybe let's do 15, see how that feels. And obviously the more we add, the heavier the scene's gonna get. And that all depends on what we're kind of shooting for here. So we're getting close here. I do kind of like this. That's not too shabby, actually. Why don't we just kind of start working in some kind of randomizes. So we're going to go ahead and bring in some effectors. We're just going to use the randomize effectors. I'm going to make sure my cloner object is highlighted so that when we go to our effectors, it automatically assigns it. So we'll go random. And once again, it defaults to these numbers. And I usually like to start over. I'm just going to zero everything out and just kind of play with the settings here. And you know what? I'm just going to change my display. That's not what I wanted. Let's do that just so we don't get that. Because the Fresnel is pretty thick. So let's just kind of offset the stuff here. Maybe go to our top view, see what we're looking at here. On our Y, don't want to offset it too much. Maybe do like a 5. I might need to do a little more. Once again, try 10 here, see how that looks. And it's randomizing pretty nicely. We don't want to overkill too much because we'll be able to break some of this up down the road a little bit. So why don't we go ahead and implement our rotation as well. And we could probably do the scale as well, but I'm going to be using the uniform option here, so we don't need to worry about separate axis scaling. Maybe kind of, you know, really not much, maybe 0.01. Let's see what that looks like here. Not too bad, 0.03, 0.05, there we go. Getting some relatively good results here. Okay, now our rotation is going to really help out here. So once again, let's try, a little bit at a time. Kind of break it up. That might be a little overkill. Maybe 2, maybe 3 on our pitch here. And our banking, yeah, we could see this is getting a nice effect. So it's breaking it up rather nicely. Yeah, so let's just kind of test render real quick here. And it's, yeah, you know, it doesn't look too bad. I think we could probably afford to bring down our, kind of our height here on our little guys. So maybe we can kind of break it up just a little more. Yeah, I think that's looking pretty good. All right, and our scene is it's populated. It's looking relatively okay. You know, so why don't we go ahead and I think we gotta create our top layer and kind of sandwich them together. So why don't we, basically let's just instance this, you know, go ahead and I'm going to rotate this. I'm going to grab our band rotation band here, hold shift and kind of, that's definitely not what I wanted. Hold it down and go 5 degree increments here and just 180. And, let's just bring this up, kind of line it up, kind of eyeball it here. So my scene's feeling a little heavy, trying to navigate around here. But but that is bound to happen. So here we go. We have our scene populated. And it looks pretty good. I'm kind of liking the direction of this. You can kind of see how it's broken up a little bit. You know, if you go above it, everything looks a little bit more linear. So we can definitely play with our cloner attributes, positioning our scale, our rotation, and kind of bring that out. But I'm liking this. And we got enough to play here with our cameras and just kind of frame everything nicely. There we go. And you know, we haven't brought in any lighting, but even without the lighting, we're getting that nice Fresnel effect. So okay, this is good. So let's go ahead and end this lesson, and then we'll in the next lesson we'll move on to really and finessing here with our scene. I did revert back and change my texture a little bit because working with such heavy Fresnel, it's hard to get a lot of lighting effects. So I kind of went back and kind of found a little bit of balance, and I changed my overall gradient color, my color channel, to a lighter color instead of being so dark, so we could help some of those shadow highlights come up. So one thing that I'm probably going to do here, and a lot of illustrations that we've seen with these membranes, is that you kind of see them in a side view. You kind of see them like that, and then you see our little proteins kind of enter. But what I'm going to do is I'm actually just going to pivot this 90 degrees. And the reason is I feel we can have a little better camera control over what we're doing, and get a better angle at what we're going to be doing. And I feel that we kind of have a little bit more of an airy, kind of floating feeling to what's going on here. Just kind of switching it up a little bit, breaking the rules. Sometimes you just got to break the rules when it comes to the imagination, right? So here we kind of have this. No lights, no real anything to make this pop, but this is kind of our basic render. So it's pretty washed out. It's pretty flat. So let's start bringing some lights in and see what we can do with this. And I'm just going to kind of start with a target light here. And let's go to our separate views, kind of set up our target. And I'm assuming probably in this area we're going to want it. Kind of line this up. And as we all know, everything is kind of trial and error with this stuff. So let's kind of work in angling our light. I'm going to actually start out with working with some soft shadows and get our detail, get some fall off. I'm going to use the inverse square. So we have a little bit more control of how our fall off is. And considering we're working with such a heavy Fresnel, I'm going to actually crank up our shadow, our density here. Try to kind of override a little bit of that so we can get a nice balance. So it's kind of, we have that flashlight effect where you're just going to have that zone lighting. Like I said, we're still getting that heavy Fresnel down here, but we're going to be doing a lot of work in post as well. So, you know, we're striving to get a good look. We're not striving at this point to get a perfect look. That will definitely come later. So let's just kind of roughly get our lights going here. Kind of take a look at that. Maybe bring our fall off in just a little bit. And I'd actually like to change the color of our light a little bit, maybe more of a kind of a dull yellow here. And we already have a lot of warm colors going on here, but I kind of want to keep it warm and soft. That's what I'm kind of shooting for here. Bring that in a smidge. Maybe angle it just a little differently here. We can pull this out. And I don't want to be too rough. I'm actually going to duplicate my light See what we can do, kind of getting some kind of some backlighting going on here. Pull it back just so our fall off isn't as heavy as our front light. Maybe change the lighting to kind of a cooler color. Kind of see if that does anything for us. And like I said, a lot of this is going to be trial and error. I think we're okay with that, just to start out with. So I'm just going to kind of hide these for now. I think one thing I'd like to play with here is maybe getting a deformer in here. Why don't we kind of work with maybe a twist? Just to see, considering that, you know, this thing's kind of floating around in micro space and getting pushed around by all the forces in there. You know, we might want to kind of break this up a little bit. So I'm just going to pivot this 90. Hold down shift. Let's do that. Let's see. We can go probably a little bit more. Whoop. Definitely don't want to do that. A little overkill there. And let's try 500 on that. A little more. Let's do 1200. Kind of scoot it over. Let's just see what we can get with this. And we're going to change this to unlimited, just so we don't have to get our exact dimensions to our geometry. And put this in our null. See what happens here. So breaking it up a little bit. I'm going to hide that just so we can get a good look. Maybe negative that. There's a lot we can do here. Just trying to break it up a little bit here. A little too much. Keep it at 15. And then we're going to want to focus on setting up our camera and then getting a good angle. I'm just trying to see how our deformer looks here. Yeah, let's bring a camera in. Go ahead and select that. And let's work with some focal length here. This might be a little too wide. This is a flavor thing too. Usually something like this, you kind of want to keep relatively tight. And then normally you'd see probably some lens distortion going on, which we'll have in the post-process, but you know, I think we just kind of want to keep it relatively tight. Yeah, I'm going to kind of play with our camera here. Get maybe a subtle, let's kind of bank that a little bit here. That's all right. It's not too much, just by a few degrees. And we can kind of move around. So you're getting the idea. And like I said, we're not going for perfection with our first initial phase here. You know, are going to be rendering these out and then bringing them into Photoshop and doing some serious magic to the look and the feel. And I think I'm going to want to, in our next phase, working in 3D here, I think we're going to want to kind of create a small handful of kind of molecular geometry, just kind of floating around. And that'll be a separate element, but, you know, it'll be simple, but it'll help us in the long run to give a feel of movement and other life around our little cellular wall here. So yeah, let's, you know, we can spend as much time as we want on this lighting, get a really good effect, but ultimately we just want to kind of have something where it's going to kind of define our foreground here, kind of highlight the front, and then kind of fade out in the back, and through our fall off and some of our shadowing, we can try to do that. Once again, very basic setup, but in the long run, once we do the passes, render passes, it's going to really make this pop. So Yeah, let's in the next lesson kind of focus on really kind of